Well, if you're facing the fight of your life against cancer or Parkinson's, you'll want to have access to the latest drug treatments. But unfortunately, sometimes they can be a long time coming, with approval by Australian authorities taking years in some cases. Now there are online services offering to import the drug for you, and it's completely legal. Entrepreneur Sjaak Vink set up the Social Medwork to do just that, and he joins us this morning on Studio 10. Good morning, Sjaak. Thank you so much for joining us. So,
good morning.
What treatments can you import, and it's completely legal, is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. It's completely legal, and it is treatments for life-saving treatment for life-threatening or debilitating diseases. So it's not for catching a cold or something. It's really the seriously diseases.
And these are drugs that have been approved overseas or being used overseas,
yeah,
but for some reason haven't been approved here. Is that a problem of the Australian authorities, the Therapeutic Goods Administration, taking too long to approve these drugs?
You know, Joe, I travel around the world, and in every country they ask me this same question. It is not
right.
Your Australian problem. It is a problem that exists all over the world.
Right.
As a matter of fact, we still don't have a globally harmonized approval system. And as long as we don't have that, the problem exists in Europe, whereas there's drugs available and approved in the US, but it's also the other way around. We
right.
also have drugs available that is approved in Japan, and that American patients are eager to get.
Right.
So it's really a global problem.
So how is it legal to import the drugs and take them here if they're not legally available here?
Well, as a matter of fact, already many, many years ago, I think in Australia, even about 35 years ago, something like that, TGA already regulated this very well. There's the personal import scheme here in Australia. And such regulations are available all over the world, but numbers show that they are hardly being used, and that's really a pity for patients. Mm.
So how do patients order the drugs? I mean, how do you police it, and do they need a script or
Well, you know, it's really seriously diseases. Eh? It is not just like going to the grocery or so. It is really that you can find the drug yourself online. Eh? We try to be as transparent as possible, because we think, I know from experience, because I've been there with my family and friends in that situation myself. And we know that transparent information on pricing, on the drugs, on the results in the treatments of the treatments is very important. So they can find that online. But after that, they have to go to their physician.
And would Australian doctors be willing to do that?
Well, we can see all over the world, and also in Australia, that doctors are willing to do so in cases that patients are running out of treatment options.
Well,
and empty-handed.
Let's look at the cost. I mean, a month's supply of the breast cancer drug, not approved yet in Australia, is around $10,000?
Yeah, by heart, I think about that, yeah.
And then the lowest price that you've got, you add a service on top of that?
Because the prices are set by the pharmaceutical industry.
Mm-hmm.
So the pharma company is setting the prices, and fortunate enough, we are more and more heading towards value-based pricing. So it's really something that the pharma companies and the insurance companies have to work on. But we simply give the prices of the pharma company, and then we have a small service fee. The service fee is, by the way, included in that price already.
So a motor neurone drug, the cheapest one is around $1,000.
Yeah, approximately like that. Yeah, that's
so
the radical cost.
It's still
for
quite expensive. How do people afford this?
Yeah, that's different per country. That is a problem in some of the countries. In France, for instance, the system is more or less the same as it is here in Australia, but the system also includes the reimbursement automatically for every patient, so a patient never has to pay for it themselves. In Germany, for instance, it is every now and then that the Krankenkasse pays for it, and sometimes a patient has to pay for it themselves. And in Australia, most of the time, patients have to pay for it themselves.
Yeah, and what's the service fee? 25%, 10%?
No, 10% at most.
So, Sjaak,
it's really a couple of hundreds of dollars, not more than that.
If you've been diagnosed with a form of cancer, say, for example, breast cancer, and your oncologist says to you or your doctor, you've run out of options, we need to look at experimental drugs or experimental treatments, Do they then get that advice from the oncologist about what medication they can use and then import it?
Yeah, always. It is always like that.
That's right. You need to get a script from
it. It is really you as a patient, and on the breast cancer, that it's really a great example, and it's really important to me personally, because I lost my mother-in-law on breast cancer, and I've got two daughters myself. So breast cancer is really a topic in our family. And there's a breast cancer treatment available. It's already approved 2 years ago in the US. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, till now, it is still not available for patients here in Australia. And I think that's really ridiculous, and that should change.
It is, it's crazy, and the difference between when something's approved and the cost of it and when it hasn't been, it really upsets me. And you set up this website because of that, because you lost your mother-in-law and another guy called Steve as well.
Out of personal reasons, yeah. Yeah.
And that was what did you sort of rail against, I suppose, the unfairness of it?
Well, you know, you guys are, what I very much like about your program is you are jumping really from the chocolate cake to the bracelets, and then all of a sudden the diseases. That's life. That is what life is all about. It is, you know, my family, my friends, they love life. And some of them, they just have bad luck. It is not that they are sometimes even more healthier in their lifestyles than I am, and they have bad luck, and they are all of a sudden diagnosed with a serious disease, and that is really terrible. Well, in such a case like the breast cancer, there should be transparent information on what is available globally. Yes. You know, if Adele has the latest song, it will be available all over the world away, within 24 hours.
What sort of reaction do you get globally? I mean, how many people are now going to the website?
Yeah, patients are responding in a very positive way, of course. Physicians are also very positive, but there are some are more conservative and say, well, let's take a look at it and let's not be too quick on it, but more and more you can see that everyone is understanding that, you know, everything in life is about globalization, whether it's the Adele song or the latest James Bond movie or whatever. And we all understand that it is ridiculous when it's about life, the most important and precious thing in life, your health, that you should wait for 2 more years. Whereas in the US, for instance, the patients are already treated with it and most of the time successfully.
Well, Sjaak, some of those people don't have 2 years because they've got cancer, haven't they?
They don't. They are running out of time.
Thanks for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it.
Very welcome.